Here it is. The Ohio State Buckeyes team against Utah. That's right. The Ohio State Buckeyes team against the Utah. Go Ohio State Buckeyes. Utah Youth.
Wants the football first, put that offense on the field against a shorthanded Ohio State defense.
Rose Bowl game.
Kirk Street adding our wishes to you for a healthy and happy 2022. No place we'd rather start the new year than right here. The sixth time you've had the honor of working again together, and the 14th, my partner. That's a record for analysts, man.
Yeah, thanks, man.
You could give a clinic to Utah, because this is the first time for these guys, and they are just sky high to be here.
Yeah.
The Ram truck takes a look at their season, which started off like a nightmare. Kirk, they're 1-2. Sputtering. They turned things around when Cam Rising came on at quarterback, and here they are, ranked number 11.
Yeah, I think it's a great point about Cam Rising being inserted after that 1-2 start, because they became a different team, a team that became more confident, and as they won, that confidence continued to grow and grow. Devin Lloyd is a catalyst to me, the All-American linebacker, and a guy that could have gone out and played in the NFL a year ago, but decided he had unfinished business. He wanted to get his team to a Pac-12 championship. He wanted to get his team to a Rose Bowl, something that never done, and he's been able to achieve that. He won the Pac-12, had a great game in the Oregon game, and now here his team is, first time ever. But I don't think getting here is his goal. He wanted to win this championship and then be on to the NFL as a first rounder. We'll see if he can get it done.
Meanwhile, for Ohio State, you know there are opt-outs to some key guys. Four key players, two first-team All-American wide receivers, Chris Olave and Garrett Wilson, 135 catches between them. But Haskell Garrett, the anchor of that defensive line, also opting out. And so does the left tackle, Nick Petty-Frere, a problem against this Utah defense. A total, Kirk, of five Ohio State starters on defense not going today.
Yeah, I mean, that's been the big question leading into this matchup is Ohio State with the opt-outs. Been around Ryan Day, I think he thinks, even though until the game goes on, he thinks that he has a team that's fired up and ready to play. There's a look at Chris Olave, but these young receivers that we'll introduce you to throughout this game, they've been waiting for their opportunity, all incredibly talented, kind of a precursor for what you'll see from Ohio State's offense in 2022.
So Noah Ruggles, graduate kicker, transfer from North Carolina, to boot it away. Britton Covey.
Utah Youth.
Game with the Utes, a very dangerous returner, is back deep. Here we go. Ruggles kicks it short. This will be returnable. And Covey comes up to take it from the nine. Brittany Covey. He's dangerous. He's taken four in the house between punts and kickoffs. And Utah grad Hollywood.
Well, that'll be your sideline.
You can hear that big ovation, and there's a good reason. There is a huge Utah contingent here. The school record for attendance was set earlier this year, 52,724 in a game.
Go Ohio State Buckeyes.
Career he has had. He was at Texas. He transfers into Utah. Actually played against USC last year as a starter. Got injured. Had surgery. Couldn't throw a football until June. In the meantime, Charlie Brewer transfers over from Baylor. Wins the job in those first three games. All the while, the team continued to believe in him. Even with the backup, he's voted captain. And eventually, he wins the job in week four.
Dual threat guy. Tremendous scrambler. Has to elude the rush and throws it down at the feet of Brent Keefe. Their top receiver, another one of those tight ends. So early pressure there Jerron Cage, who has to fill in with Haskell Garrett not there.
Yeah, a good job not necessarily biting on to that play action look. Ohio State's defense, eye discipline, has been the big focus for Matt Barnes and the Buckeye defensive staff because, as you said, all the tight ends, they give you a lot of different looks. Something, it'll look like a run, it'll be play action. Off of that, really can challenge these linebackers and safeties today.
Tavian Thomas in the back.
Get him!
Got the ball on second and 10. The Ohio native barrels forward for a gain into Buckeye territory. Figure he's going to be extra inspired today.
Nice job in the left side. Olasani, the left tackle, does a nice job. 71 builds the left guard. Watched him open this up, create that crease. And once you give him a chance, Thomas at 6'2", 220, to get downhill, he's a handful. Chris, you bring up a great point. Played at Dayton Dunbar High School in Southwest Ohio and wanted to go, would love to play for Ohio State, but like a lot of recruits, not everybody can. And he has a chip on his shoulder today.
You fake it to him, then Rising shows his wheels and weaves for a 6-yard gain. A couple years at Cincinnati for Tavian Thomas before transferring in. Smashed the Utah record with 20 rushing touchdowns this year.
Yeah, and you anticipate that this is a power running team, and then you're reminded like that, the Cam Rising. He doesn't keep it a lot, maybe 5 or 6 times a game, but enough to make you have to respect it. And I bet you today probably runs it a little bit more to try to get to the edge of the Buckeye defense.
Cooper, you see, no Haskell Garrett, no Antoine Jackson, no Cody Simon, the linebacker. They'll test the heart of that Buckeye defense with their power running game. A little too much adrenaline for Rising on that pitch.
And let's not forget the last time that Ohio State went out and played against Michigan.
Rose Bowl Championship.
97 yards rushing with all those players that you mentioned. 7.2 yards a carry. And remember, early in the year against Oregon, they struggled to defend the run. So that was a big part of the buildup of this game. How would Ohio State physically match up against the Utah team that lives by running the ball and winning the line of scrimmage?
Talent, yeah, but inexperience for sure. Seven Banks, Marcus Williamson, two starting DBs, also out of this game with injuries, and a timeout before this 3rd and 4. As the Utes trying to draw first blood in this opening possession, some confidence shown by Kyle Whittingham. Most would defer. He said, no, give me the football. Let's go right at this Buckeye defense.
Yeah, that kind of surprises you because he's a defensive-oriented coach, former defensive coordinator. If you go way back, to Urban Meyer. Urban Meyer was the head coach at Utah and doing a great job in Salt Lake. Takes the Florida job, and Kyle Whittingham takes over as a head coach. So he's been there for a number of years, 17 years now, which is remarkable that he's been there that long. But he is a defensive guy. You'd always expect him to win the toss and defer, but it shows you the confidence he has.
Yeah, Kirk, he's a constant in the conference, 17 years. Look how many head coaches the other Pac-12 teams have had since Kyle's been head coach. 6 for the Bucs is the most in Power 5. But no one has fewer than 3 head coaches. 17 years, second only to Kirk Ferentz, as long as Mike Gundy just comes off a big bowl win.
We asked him to describe his program. He said blue-collar, disciplined, structure, accountable, family-oriented, love each other. Older guys on this team always help mold and kind of show the younger players the way.
Buckeyes crowding the line on this 3rd and 4 play. They give it to Thomas, and he runs right into the teeth of the defense. And they tried to play power football, but Zach Harrison got there. Stover, who's a tight end, shifting over to linebacker, playing early.
Yeah, they walked him up. They bring in another linebacker, and they hold the edge there. You also saw Court Williams get in there. So Ohio State expecting the run, outnumber up front, and a nice job of Stover holding that edge. Impressive.
How about a tight end? Said, listen, we're shorthanded. Go over there.
Yeah.
They love his energy and enthusiasm.
And instincts as a linebacker going back to his days in high school.
And Beasley on the punt. Smith and Jigba, the electric receiver, the fair catch at the 9-yard line. And that's where C.J. Stroud and the Buckeye offense will take over for their first possession.